It's Sunday. You know what time it is, everybody. It's time for another point of view. Let's start things off with a little chat, shall we? Let's talk, Internet. The subject matter of this segment is a hot-button issue for some. The legalization of recreational use of cannabis, or marijuana, or pot, whichever name you use to refer to it. If you are in your teens, 20s, maybe even your 30s, I'm not sure, then you probably are very aware of this topic, depending on whether you live in a city where it is illegal to possess. Interestingly enough, when you look at legalization of marijuana on a global scale, as the map illustrates, countries where marijuana is legal, or essentially legal, are in the minority. It is only when you take into account nations or regions within the nations where it is illegal but decriminalized or unenforced that it looks to be divided closer to 50-50. Just listen to the short list of whole nations where cannabis is officially legal. Uruguay, Bangladesh, the Netherlands, and North Korea. That's the list of whole nations. And before anyone chimes in, remember that I'm talking about recreational use of marijuana, not medical use. In the United States of America, there are currently 4 states out of the 50 states that allow recreational use. Those states are Alaska, Washington, the state, Oregon, and Colorado. That's it. 4 out of 50 states. Not even 10%. Various groups seem discontent with this in the states, as a push for national legalization of recreational use of marijuana seems to be, every year, becoming a talking point. Even among current presidential hopefuls in the election, coming up next year, legalization of marijuana is a topic of interest, though it's often brought up in relation to whether the candidate would continue what is considered a failed war on drugs by the US government. But why am I talking about this? Well, Internet, specifically young people of the Internet, I wanted to let you know that if you really feel passionate about this topic, yes, you can keep posting all those pro-marijuana legalization images or facts about how it's not nearly as bad as other substances that are legal, but ultimately, vote on the issue if it means that much to you. Posting images on social media to raise awareness is nice, you know, it can inform others, but it doesn't matter if you don't take a politically active role in pressuring your local, state, or national government to include it as a ballot issue in the upcoming election. Where do I stand on legalization of recreational use of cannabis? Well, to be honest, when I consider the fact that there are countries where things like cigarettes or alcohol, which can be just as dangerous, are considered legal substances to consume, I struggle to see the rationale of making the sale of cannabis illegal. Then again, I've never touched or used the stuff, nor would I even if it were legal to do so. I don't care if that makes me a square in your eyes, I just don't see the appeal. Feel free to tell me about your stance on recreational cannabis use down in the comment sections. I'd like to hear it. Moving on to something less controversial. Nature hates us. Folks, this past week, Mexico and Central America took a beating by the weather. There was widespread flooding in Central America due to what was initially a tropical depression, which later became a tropical storm, and later grew rapidly into a Category 5 hurricane. Hurricane Patricia, which formed in the western hemisphere of the Pacific Ocean, became the second Pacific hurricane on record to make landfall as a Category 5 this past week. It broke world records in doing so because it was the most intense tropical cyclone ever recorded in the western hemisphere in terms of barometric pressure, and was the strongest globally in terms of reliably measured maximum sustained winds. There have been 6 fatalities attributed to the storm so far, 4 of them from El Salvador, 1 in Guatemala, and 1 in Nicaragua. As far as how much damage the hurricane did when it made landfall in Mexico, it was surprisingly limited. Though there are still mudslide warnings in effect, only 1 death has been reported thus far. Just goes to show you, nature. You may hate us, but we can take it. Okay then, last segment. Here's a recommendation. It's still October, so let's go with yet another story about spooky creatures. Freaks, or rather, performers in a freak show. Turns out they just want to live everyday lives like you and me, or something as close to a normal life as possible while living in a traveling performance show. Be they Snake Boy, exceptionally tall man, a person capable of regrowing limbs, a dancing spider, a man who can eat anything, a bearded lady, a wolfman, or even vampires. The show's got everything. The 12 books in question, as they are a series of books, are called The Cirque du Freak Series by Darren Shan. It's a story about a boy named Darren who steals a poisonous dancing spider from one of the performers with a terrible secret. After an accident with the dancing spider and his best friend, the boy must return the spider and ask for the performer to give him the antivenom to save his best friend's life. In return, the boy must give up his humanity, fake his death, leave his past life, including family and friends, behind, and join the Cirque du Freak in a winding story where strange is just part of the scenery. Links in the description. Well, folks, that's it for this installment. Next Sunday will be the start of November, which means Halloween is this upcoming Saturday, a time of year when the streets fill up with all kinds of ghouls, goblins, ghosts, and galore. Don't fret, though. I'm sure they're friendly. So just enjoy the show. Remember, kids, don't do drugs. Substance abuse is no joke.